Ooh. Ooh. Mo. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy. We run, made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy. That was a runner, made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under.
Folks, it is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the Hoppin' French Quarter at the Caesars Superdome.
The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week, and we are underway from the Superdome. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Do right there as they're going to bury him in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11.
Now Lawrence to throw.
Escaping the pressure right. And that is incomplete.
So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Here comes the Saints punter now. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. A 40-yard punt, no return. And the Panthers will take over now first and 10.
They're on 19-yard line.
They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor.
They find some open field here. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
That's a nice run right there. Able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Looking to throw. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Carolina. A great effort there. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Saints nothing.
Set now to kick this one away. And off it goes. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose.
Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And Patterson not going to return this. It'll come out to the 25.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here.
And, Charles, you look at this defense. Yeah, they're a confident bunch, and they're going to need to be. They're facing a group here that is seeking a fifth consecutive victory.
And this head coach knows all about motivational tactics. He was touting his unit all week, saying, we've got a locker room full of guys ready to step up, ready to go. And he believes that.
Eluding the pressure right. Going right side here, and that's complete.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 5.
And already down 7-0 after the touchdown a minute ago. So a 3 and out here would not be ideal for them. Nice job finding his receiver there. And they get the first down.
And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were fantastic a week ago in that win over Houston.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game. And I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9.
Now Lawrence. That's into the crowd and intercepted.
Picked off right around the 43. And the return across midfield into the 46-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's 2nd down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Looking right sideline, that's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end or wide receiver, that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand that without a quarterback, they don't make the plays that they make. They also don't feel like they get enough credit for bailing out some of the throws the quarterbacks make.
Absolutely. Takes 2 to tango.
2nd and 8. From the gun, it's Taylor.
Oh, able to avoid him. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
43 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times.
Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Brings up 2nd and 5. 46, 46, 46. Come on. Watch the slam.
from the gun. They'll try to run it.
And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Taken down at the 11-yard line. It's a gain of a yard.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for three. And the 13-year man puts it through, and the lead moves to 10-0. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice win for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They find themselves down 10-0 early after the interception on their opening drive led to a field goal.
So now they've got to pick up the mantle a little bit. You mentioned the team's down 10. They've helped contribute to that. How are they going to get their team back into this ball game? Run the offense that you think is going to be effective and execute it at a high level.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The Saints on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Now a give right side. Richards breaks through the contact. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. From the gun, he'll hand this off. No, bottled up, fumble. It's out, it's loose, and it's picked up by the Panthers. 20, 10. And he takes it into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery and a touchdown for the Panthers. And maybe that's the perils of being a rookie running back in the NFL. I mean, look, it's not easy to hold on to the ball at any level with these talented guys. But in this league, you can learn a lesson early.
Without a doubt, and what a tough reminder for any running back, especially a rookie. The things you got away with in college probably won't work so well in the NFL.
Now it's Patterson. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do when we look at the stat sheet? We go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to 3rd down. The Saints on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
When you struggle on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Every now and then I can speak from experience, because I do know, as a defender, it is awfully hard to stay with your man on these crossing routes, because even if you don't get picked, there's a danger of being picked, either by one of their receivers or maybe by your own defender. And on that play, that worked quite well.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
They go play action with Lawrence. A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch.
Time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive here, second and 11. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And for a second straight play, just nowhere to go thanks to this Carolina defense. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Lawrence. And this is going to be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And the Panthers are going to have it here as they start at their own seven.
And that's what we've seen from this defense all year long, because they've been so good at finding ways to take the football away. And they just gave us another example right here. A strong defense, that's something you're going to need to rely on come playoff time. And this crew has got one. There's no doubt about that, Brandon.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll set up a throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Taylor. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On play action, they'll throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Here's the Panthers punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. 47-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence.
And for the third time here, this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Merriman. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
A loss of a yard brings up second and 11.
Second and 11. Flushed out right. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. They go play action here on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal.
And I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So that challenge, a successful one. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Oh, good footwork on the spin. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. A chance to really put this game out of reach. Here's third and goal. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. Jonathan Taylor, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are able to add on to their first half lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the route is on here in this first half. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From his end zone, here comes Patterson. No return here for Patterson, so they'll begin things at the 25-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with a 3-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. There's Tremble, the tight end. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
First down. First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
On first down, Lawrence. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
That's complete out right to the tight end, Tremble. And diving to try to get the first down. He's going to be a little bit shy of the marker. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. As it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. On third and 1, it's Lawrence. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Richards. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. Final play of the half. It's Lawrence. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this is caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. So we come upon halftime. Intermission here with the visiting Panthers. Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number 3. Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Now it's the backup, Mayfield. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone, possibly got a little bit too greedy.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Trayvon Merrig. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. Extra point right down the middle, and the lead will swell by one more.
Saints nothing.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who could make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else. Or maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second and five at the 46-yard line.
They'll look to throw again. He finds his man complete. That's Richards. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 36.
First and 10 at the 36.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. He finds his man complete. That's Richards. So nothing doing there. And that'll make it second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch. But even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 28th. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. That is now 5 interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
At the 45-yard line.
And incomplete on the deep ball.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
They'll drop to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to air one out. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
And nowhere for him to go again. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. From the gun, it's Lawrence.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. This is caught inside the 15. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A big connection on that one. 34 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10.
Play action. It's Lawrence.
Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Second down and goal. Lawrence. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Touchdown! A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit.
That touchdown was for all the fantasy people out there. May not change the final outcome, but some points were scored, and maybe some of the people at home are really excited to get those.
They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. That's caught at the one. And he'll get in. And they're going to draw themselves 2 points closer. So they're able to throw it in for the two-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here because if you do get it intercepted and it's returned by the defense, that's 2 points for them. But he identified an open target and put it right on him.
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. A great effort there. 39 yards.
And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Extra point attempt to follow here. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Saints 8.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men.
And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. They'll run on first down. It's Richards. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Yeah, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Escaping the pressure right. That caught by Trimble. And they'll get this down to the 10.
That's a big league job there, getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence.
Eluding the pressure right. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play.
Back now here live in New Orleans.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal.
Here we go. 51 the mic, boy, 51.
They go play action now. Lawrence. Caught on the slant. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the 6 here on fourth and goal. They'll try and run for it. And they are going to stop him on 4th and 1 as they'll wind up going backwards. They stop him up short on 4th and goal from the 1. And the Panthers defense able to deliver the goal line stand. He's going to float this one deep right side. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
At the 12-yard line.
61.
Now Lawrence. Flushed out right. Throw out right, taken in by Patterson. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play. And that'll lead here to a 3rd down. Lawrence will throw. And it's caught. Touchdown, Saints. Tommy Trimble hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Saints get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Now the Saints offense will remain on the field and go for 2. They'll try and throw for it. Flush to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a 2-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense. Right?
Yeah, that's true. You've said that before. Well, 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. Extra point splits the uprights, and that will extend this big lead. So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a good chance to pin them deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. On play action, Lawrence.
Going for the deep ball. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On second and 10, Lawrence. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. The Saints on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and 9. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
It's a gain of 28 yards. And the Saints, first down. First and 10 at the 41.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Buying time to his left. And some room to run now. And Lawrence going to smartly hit the deck here as he is able to pick up the first down in the process. Now Lawrence on first down.
And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he's taken down inside the 30.
That's another Saints first down. First and 10 of the 28-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence
escaping the pressure right. And I think the ball's out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the foot.
And this is caught! And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. Lutz good on the extra point, and the lead is down to 24. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And it looks like the Panthers puts it on the carpet. It's out. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And he's got a first down as he's going to be taken down. But a very nice pickup there just in front of the two-minute warning.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the... And this will be caught, and the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Well, they mentioned this week, Charles, they had a couple kinks on offense that they wanted to fix. I would say they're pretty well fixed.
There's no doubt about that. I mean, just about everything they've run has been successful in this one. And if I'm the defensive coordinator, I'm done with this, right? I have no answers for anything. In fact, I'd probably send a note to the clock operator. Let it run.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
They're on 17-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And their four-game win streak very much in jeopardy as they go to work here late with a first and 10.
He's going to let it fly. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And now here's another interception. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthersons are going to take over at their own 28-yard line.
CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Here's Lawrence.
And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Again, it's Lawrence. And this is caught. Well, they get one back. Picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Saints, 27.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they just continue to roll right along, really. This has the looks of yet another victory as they hope to polish it off here in quarter number four. And some space here. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
That's going to be a long check, 33.
Now it looks like he'll throw here and give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes, and that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Point after, right down the middle, and the lead will swell by one more.
From his end zone, here comes Patterson. And Patterson not going to return this. It'll come out to the 25.
Six,
Check 26, check 26.
A final shot now for Lawrence. The pressure gets to Lawrence, and he'll go down.
Okay, baby. Okay, baby.
Oh, ain't that something?
Hey, take your shot.
Good job.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Panthers, they continue to make their case as a Super Bowl favorite as they move to 13-1. And they'll return home next week to take on the LA Rams. Meanwhile, for the Saints, their playoff hopes take a hit as they drop to 7-7. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against San Francisco.
on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I hate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Eat them up. If I don't do nothing, I serve. Really, I'm super absurd. Got them all dead like birds. Leave a speechless, no words. Leave a speechless, no words. Coming in first, I'm third. Tight fit, showing my lights, camera, action like verbs.
Going hard for my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer.
And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Yeah. What's up?
Eat them up, yo.
Yeah, I was on a little diet.
Eat them up.
Ready for the summer. Even if they don't
eat up,
we can give it to them.
Eat them up. I could do it better than he can. Really like that, no pretend. Had to get him back just to revenge. I'ma go to Paris for the weekend. I'ma go with him for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I be speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding.
Section where you're not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted. Playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting with do for a purse. Disgusting with.